This edition of Computer Club Lesson was recorded on January the 16th, 2017. This edition is all about free stuff.
Hello, welcome to Computer Club Lesson. This episode is brought to you by the Binary Guys. All right, everyone, it's 1 o'clock again and time to start once again. And here she comes,
Brenda.
The late Brenda.
I mean, technically you're not late. We're just starting early.
Started, said to somebody, don't phone after 12:45, so the phone is 16 minutes to 1. Yeah, fine, yeah, don't go.
Yeah, I've had those.
Yeah.
I've had those. Okay, here we are back at it again. I just want to remind everyone here and in video land that after today I will be doing once every 2 weeks. So not next week, but the following week, essentially at the end of the month, I will be sending out emails for the days that we are going to have classes. And in the meantime, if anyone here or in video land has questions, please email me your questions, and if you need them taken care of right away, I will, and I will also save the question for class time if it's something that everybody else needs to know. So please do that. All right, today we are going to once again look at stuff from the internet for your computer for the low price of free. Everybody loves free.
I mean, it's okay.
No, it's free is the best. So before we get into programs and things, I just want to give you a reminder about free stuff, that there is all kinds of free stuff on a web page if you know what you're looking for. As a for instance, there are websites that will give you flyers for local stores. So if you don't get their flyer in the Metro Media, or Metro Media has not delivered, you can go to these flyer pages for local stores and see what's on. Save yourself a buck. There might even be, I haven't found them, but there might even be coupons in some of these flyer locations on the internet. This one is called redflagdeals.com, and you can tell it to look locally here in Hamilton for Walmart and many other stores that are Best Buy, Amazon, you can get stuff, Canadian Tire, Home Depot. There's all kinds of things that are available to you in flyers, and in some cases there are even coupons. Now, coupons. If you can get a coupon from a website, that's great. Click on it, print it, great. Please do not go to coupon websites, because those places will download and install couponware, which you can call scumware. On your computer, they'll install these programs that will essentially take over your browser, and you will never be able to get away from them again unless you uninstall the programs. So some place like coupons.com or whatever it is, if it's all about coupons, Please don't go there because it's going to load scumware on your computer. But if you can find coupons from flyers, so much the better. Okay, because it's not, usually, it's not going to install scumware on your computer. I've got another one here that I can show you quickly. This is save.ca. Now, save.ca has coupons. And a lot of times they're for pet foods, and here's something from Shoppers. I can't just Tylenol, okay? Benylin liquid from Shoppers. There's coupons here that you can get, you know, for 40% off. Hey, that's not bad. From Michaels, that's not bad. I can live with that. So that's another place where you can go. And here again, the coupons are integrated with the flyers themselves, so you can, if you're in the coupon type, and who isn't these days, because if you can save 20% on a grocery bill and you walk out of the store having deposited $100 onto their counter, 20% is $20 better in your pocket than theirs. Okay, sometimes you have to work a little bit for it, and okay, call it your day's work for $20. Why not? Okay, so much for flyers and coupons online for free stuff. Where else can you get free stuff? How many travelers do we have here? Travelers? You're a traveler. You go traveling every once in a while.
I travel in my mind.
Yeah, he travels in his mind. He's not chemically enhanced. He can do it all by himself. Free stuff online. Go looking for it because you're going to get hotels. You're going to get, if you don't want to stay in a hotel, you can find a really nice B&B. Roadmaps to get you where you want to go if you're going to see some production in another city. Okay, you'll need a map to get there. Tickets, all of this stuff is available free online, except the tickets and the hotels. You pay for that. But to find out where they are and the best deals, okay, free online stuff, go for it. Why give somebody else your money when you don't have to? Anybody got any suggestions about free stuff that they get online?
Is Trivago in them?
Yeah, for hotels and stuff, yes. Oh. Check out those sites. Expedia, Hotels.com, Trivago, they're all good. They will give you the best hotel rooms. Yes.
The guy in St. Jacobs at Holiday Inn told us it was better to phone directly to the Holiday Inn.
Sometimes, yes, you can phone ahead and say, I'm going to be at your place in 6 weeks.
Yeah, that's what he told us. You're better off to do that.
Give me a price for that room and I'll reserve it now. Yes, in those cases, sure. But do both.
Yeah.
Check that price he gives you against a hotel room online.
Same thing. I've canceled a room in Best Western and picked the same room up on the internet for, I don't know,
yeah,
$10 or $20 cheaper.
Yeah, $10-$20 cheaper, sure. And when it comes to getting closer to your arrival date or leaving date, recheck it.
We went to a hotel, went inside to book a room, and it was a certain price. And we went outside again, phoned on the telephone, got a cheaper price.
Yeah, yep. Hotels are notorious for having desk prices and telephone prices and internet prices that are never the same.
Right.
Okay. And by the way, if it's getting late in the day, and you can go into a hotel and they will tell you that they're full, go back out to your car, get on your telephone, and book the room through your telephone, because they will give you that room. They won't tell you that it's full. Okay? They're notorious for that crap. So here again, schedules of the entertainment you want to see, schedules for tours and trips, whatever you want. They're all available online at the destination you're looking for. You might have to do just a little bit of work to find them, but they're always all out there. Travel info is always something good to look at. Now, we're going to jump away from these personal kinds of things for a minute. And something else I want to talk about is conversion services on the internet.
You can add 2 cups of flour, a stick of butter, and 200 milliliters of milk. Okay? Eh?
Yeah.
All right. They're mixing up. All right.
Imperial, metric. If you're not great with metric, you can get back to imperial. Conversion services on the internet. As a matter of fact, just bring up a Google page and type in 200 milligrams cups, and it will tell you how many cups. That kind of thing is available, and it's really easy to do if you've got your tablet or your laptop computer on the counter with you. Sure thing, it works great. How many of you have video capable cameras? You all have a video capable camera. There's where one of our next topics is going to come into. But if you don't have software on your laptop to manipulate your video, to edit it down, take out all the choppiness, all the places where the audio didn't come out properly, or just the dull stuff. Okay, you want to edit it? You can do that kind of thing online. You can find a place on the internet where you can upload your video clips, put them all together, massage them, edit them, get the sound right, put in pictures and graphics and all kinds of stuff, then download them back down to your computer, and then re-upload them back to YouTube. Or put them on a disc, or whatever you want to do. But the actual manipulation of the video is done online. Once you get it up on, once you've uploaded it to these free sites that allow you to do this. You don't have to spend hundreds and hundreds of dollars on video editing software. Video editing software like I have here, Pinnacle Studio, can cost a lot of money. But that's what I use to make the videos from our doings here. The same holds true for music. In most cases, what you're going to do is you're going to download music, or if you can find it in a streaming service. Sometimes, and here again, we'll talk about how to do this, or how to find out how to do it in a few minutes. James is going to get into that, how to use programs like Firefox to download streaming services to your computer and then redo them the way you want them, right?
Sure, I don't know, but
sure. Sure, it works.
We'll do this on the
phone. Yeah, we'll refine that a little bit when we get to James. And so music manipulation software is available on the internet. You can upload tons of songs, and then you can do what, you know, if you want into that kind of thing, you can do the mixtape. Okay, how old is that? That's 1,000 years old.
Yep, they're so-called mixtapes.
Yeah,
there's no longer tapes.
Yeah, you can put them onto one of your own streaming services, and you can listen to them to your little heart's content, and everybody else can tune into them too and tell you what a putz you are for putting that crap up there. Now, one other thing here we want to go with, and that's manipulation of text. If all you've got to work with is WordPad or Notepad, and you want to make something look a little bit more professional than WordPad will do, and you can upload the stuff to Google service in Documents and use their service. There are a couple of others around that you can use their services to make text documents look a little more professional. You can use them to edit the documents and to change the fonts and the texts and all of that stuff to make it look pretty. Enter pictures, add pictures to it, graphics, all kinds of stuff. You can do this stuff online. And guess what, folk? The low price again is free. We like free. Okay, the last thing I'm gonna go through here is programs. Programs that are free, that everybody should have on their computer. And that, for openers, is Adobe Reader. The reason that we say you need to have Adobe Reader is that Adobe products are the standard for documents that are embedded in web pages and are sent back and forth over web pages and through email. It's the standard. You make an Adobe document, and no one can change it on the other end unless they have an Adobe editor, which is extremely expensive. Adobe editor software can cost you $500. Adobe Reader is free. So when you get documents from your insurance company in email, they will come to you as Adobe documents. They cannot be changed. You can just read them. That's done that way on purpose. Other things that you might like to have besides Adobe products are Apple products, particularly iTunes and
Safari maybe
as a web browser. Not so much anymore for Windows folks. There are other opportunities out there. And Apple software, particularly iTunes, is something you might want to have. It's free. Something else you might want to have to listen to music, which is free, a free download, and we've gone through this before, is VLC Media Player. I always like to have it on every computer that I have, because there isn't anything that it won't play. I've yet to run across something that VLC cannot open and play. Some of the weirdest movie formats, and my cameras, by the way, are a weird movie format. VLC opens them up and plays them. And it can also change the format to something that another program might need to use, like Windows Media Player. You have Windows Media Player on your on your systems already, but it's not really good for music, so that's why I like VLC. It is always good to have, if not two, three different kinds of web browser. Okay, so now in Windows 10, you've got two of them already. You've got Internet Explorer 11 and 12, I think it's 12 now, and Microsoft Edge as your web browser. I like to put on the Chrome browser because I find, and I mentioned this, I believe, last week, that the Chrome browser is safer to use because it does not have some of the exploits that Internet Explorer has or Microsoft Edge has that people can exploit easily. So free here again, free software. Now, where do you get this stuff? For the most part, please go to the author's website to get it. Audacity, a favorite of mine for manipulating sound. You go to Audacity's website to get it. You don't just do a search for Audacity in Google and take the first thing that comes along, because it might not be the author's website. You have to look carefully. It might want to download from downloads.com. You don't want to do that. You'd go to the author's website to get this stuff. And if you can't get to the author's website to download it, it has been my experience that you don't need it. Find an alternative. But get your programs from the author's website. Where are we here? See anything else that we would like to have? Okay. If you're playing games on your computer on the internet from Facebook or from Pogo, you're going to need Java. How many times have we talked about, well, my computer won't play the game because the Java's too old and it won't load? So you need to do Java. You do it from java.com. You don't do it from any place else.
Actually, it's Oracle.
Oracle.com. Okay, well, you can get to it from java.com. They still have it. But it's Oracle software. So you will need that to play games if you want to play games on Facebook and Pogo and a couple of other places as well. Oh, by the way, free games, Facebook and Pogo. Facebook has some great games.
Chrome has great free games.
Yes, Pogo has even better free games.
Yeah.
Game Jolt, well, he likes them. But we talked about this. James is into first-person shooters.
I know. We all have our hang-up. We all got something.
Yes. Yeah. I mean, anybody here into button-mashing first-person shooters? No. James, you're alone in that.
I play every genre.
Okay.
Horror.
Yep.
Which
are, for the most part, what we call button mashers. No strategy involved, just...
Chess.
Yes.
Back to Adobe Reader. Mine updated the other day.
Yep.
When it did, then when it went into, it came up to Chrome, and it said that they just did their update and whatever is in there can change everything in Chrome. Do you
yep.
want to kick it out of there? Yes.
Okay. What you did, because I just did this morning, if you ever get this back, next time say okay.
Oh. I throw everything out.
Yeah. Well, what happened? And I just got this morning, so I think I can talk about it with some authority where I couldn't last week because I hadn't got it yet. The Chrome browser downloaded and installed an extension.
Yeah, it said
extension.
Yeah.
For the Chrome browser. And then it said to you, okay, I'm ready to enable this extension. It's going to make these changes. You got frightened and said no, and it disabled the extension.
Okay.
Now, if you, I'm going to open a Chrome window here, and you might be able to get it back by going to the three buttons over here to customize, and then going to settings. And over on the side here, you'll see extensions. Okay, if you click on extensions, there it is, the Adobe Acrobat. If it's there, all you have to do is just click enable.
No, it's not there.
Okay, not there?
No.
All right, well, then you'll have to download the extension again. Or it may do it by itself, it's hard to say, if it made it all go away. So I think that's really what you need to look at for free programs for your computer. The other one it always is LibreOffice. Okay, if you don't have an Office suite, LibreOffice is the best. Beyond that, it all depends on how you want to use your computer online. If you want to be able to take files from your laptop and put them on your desktop really, really easily without using thumb drives, okay, the thing that you need to do is get Dropbox. From Dropbox.com, you can get yourself an account at Dropbox.com. You can upload all kinds of stuff through the web page, but they give you an opportunity to put a program on your computer which will do this for you. Once you've loaded the program on your computer, it will give you in your File Explorer a Dropbox extension, okay, which will talk directly to Dropbox and all of the files that you have put up there. So you can just drag stuff from your computer to Dropbox. It goes up to the cloud. When you've done that, you can go to your other computer where you want this, go to Dropbox, just drag it from Dropbox to wherever you want it on your computer. It downloads. It's really, really great. I use Dropbox to store stuff. When I go to clients' homes, I don't have to take a lot of thumb drives and stuff. It's all on Dropbox. I can just log in and get my stuff on the client's computer. That's neat. Okay, so there we go. That's another freebie that we should talk about. Beyond that, I think everything else I have here might be a little bit beyond you and be of no particular use to you, unless you want to get into things like editing movies and editing photographs. There is free stuff out there to do that. Free programs to edit movies and to edit photographs, but if you're not into that kind of thing as a hobby, you don't need it.
When you say edit photographs, do you mean cut them down and take what you don't need off?
Yes, and also it can do a really great job changing the contrast, changing the lighting. Does a good job. Most of them now do a really great job of red eye. Okay, so if your flash has gone off and there's all those cat's red eyes in your,
unless you're trying to go for like a hellish landscape and get the horns and whatnot.
Yeah, but here again, this stuff is also available online to do photograph manipulation. Okay, and just look for it as you know. Open up a Google page and start looking for it, and you will find these things everybody has something. Everybody has an offering of some sort. The one thing you have to be careful about with getting free programs online is, number one, are they truly free? You can get programs that do really neat stuff, but they give you a 15-day trial, and they only work. They only allow you to do 10% of what the program is capable of, or it does everything but won't save. Okay, so be careful of that. The other thing about getting free stuff online is always be careful about answering questions with your personal information. Now, they may ask you for a credit card if you want to buy. Okay, if you're thinking over buying, well, think about it for a couple of days and then go back to it. But other things like your email address, your address itself, where you're located, your mother's maiden name, and all of that kind of stuff, I would be a little bit careful about that from sites that are offering you free stuff, because the first thing that they want to do is to be able to monetize your visit. And the best way to do that is to find out all about you and then sell you to someone else. Slave. Okay? You become a slave to someone else's desires. What can I say? You might find that to be a bad thing. Okay? You might find it to be a bad thing. Just to give you an idea of a program that you may not find everywhere, but is absolutely free, and it serves a very particular purpose, is the one I just clicked on called Trelby, T-R-E-L-B-Y. Trelby is software that allows you to write movie scripts. Now, the reason I have it here is it allows me to think clearly about when I'm taking these videos and maybe re-manipulating them to go up on YouTube, or I want to make something a little plainer. I will write it down in Trelby, and it's just actually a few keystrokes to give me access to a way of thinking about making video. Okay, that was free. All they wanted was my email address, so I gave them my Gmail address. They're happy, and I get junk in my Gmail address. Okay, that pretty much does stuff from me for free stuff. I think we've talked about everything we talked, and James is going to come up now, and he's going to talk about YouTube.
Can I ask one question?
Yes.
Google Chrome. I always click on that to open things. Everybody else's comes up with the Google thing. I get MSN. I mean, I like that. I prefer it.
Because you have an MSN account.
Oh, okay.
That's why I changed it to that.
Oh, okay.
I did that.
Yes, thank you. Because I prefer it to just the Google name.
Yeah. There is...
it is using Chrome.
Yes, it is. If you click on Chrome and you get this look of the page, it's using Chrome.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. But I did that for you because you have MSN services, so I just made them come up in Chrome. Easy. Easy peasy. Okay. James, tag. You're it.
All right. I'm tired.
All right, you're going to talk about YouTube stuff, right?
Sure. That's what we agreed on. Um, So where should I begin about the magical land of YouTube? I spend my whole time there. YouTube is a video service site where everyday people can make videos of either them playing music or anything. There's some here that act out scenes from movies or make their own movies. You can pretty much find anything and everything on YouTube if you look hard enough. Typically the best way to get to it is just on the Google page. Just click these 9 squares and go to YouTube. You can just also search for YouTube.
Now, before you go a little further down the road, James, I'm going to show the folks something here that I have been doing. I have a deep and abiding interest in science. And over the last year or so, I have... yeah, all kinds of crap I've been looking at. But most of it has to do with physics. Okay? And some of the best physicists in the world of the last 50 years are available. Their lectures are available on YouTube.
Oh, Sheldon Cooper.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Men like Richard Feynman. Okay. One of the original people that worked on the atomic bomb.
He an astrophysicist? Is he an astrophysicist?
No, he was. He mainly went in for particle physics, and his main contributions to physics were particles and and the principles of name escapes me. Don't worry about it, it'll come back. But these are what I have been looking at in my account. Okay. We can go into things further. I've been looking at wait till I get down here. Things having to do with gardening and greenhouses, because I built my wife a greenhouse last fall.
You mean I built it? You just sat there and told me what to do.
You helped. I built one that looks like that. Okay. So I've been looking at gardening and greenhouses. Quantum mechanics. That's what I was trying to. From Richard Feynman. Yeah. Whoosh. Yeah. Okay, but if I've been looking at this stuff for a year now, I'm starting to get it.
Oh, good.
I'm starting to get it.
By starting, I mean, I know what quantum means.
Yeah, quantum mechanics. I know what it means.
I know what mechanics mean.
Yeah.
So we're on the quantum
if
part.
Predicting the end of the world, I don't want to know.
Oh, no, that's a long way away. And so I should say that these kinds of more robust instruction on topics that may be of interest to you that you want to dig deeply into, they are all available on YouTube. Okay, I'll give it back to you, James, but I just wanted to make that point that this, you know, it's not just cat videos.
I mean, I was going to talk about educational, but...
Yeah, okay, well...
I have a whole list here that you wrote out for me.
You can go beyond that.
In any case, yeah, there are a bunch of cat videos, dog videos, people just being stupid. that's always fun to watch. That's typically the entertainment genre. I typically watch... people make a fool of themselves while playing video games. A bit fun. But you can also listen to music of anyone. I don't know. I can't read you. What's this? Pamplemousse?
Okay, yeah.
Pamplemousse?
Pamplemousse.
Something moose?
Yeah, well, I introduced the gang to Pamplemousse 18 months ago.
I know that. We know that one.
All right. I don't. I'm too young and tired. But you can find that on YouTube. You can find other people on YouTube. You can find songs, they're probably edited versions, but you can find like Frank Sinatra songs on here and
George Carlin.
Probably.
Yeah.
Again, you can find. You can try and open up your horizon and see, watch people make their own music. There's a lot of people that do that. Most people start out here, like Justin Bieber. He started on YouTube. Yeah. No one cares about him, but I'm just saying, like, people started. Another good example was Christina Grimmie, the girl that died a couple months ago now. She also started on YouTube. I used to watch her a lot on YouTube. You can be partnered with YouTube. It's pretty much every view you get, every click on the video you get, gives you X amount of money, and then that expands.
They sell advertising on your content.
Yeah.
So in a lot of cases, before a video starts, except in these cases of science, but for entertainment, before the video starts, you're going to get a 15, 20 second commercial.
Yeah, same with games. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
You can skip it if you want.
But for you to actually make money from YouTube, you need X amount of subscribers and a certain amount of views, an average amount of views to actually get money from YouTube. But most people do make quite a good living on here. Like, this is a full-blown job if you actually do it right. So there's a lot of entertainment videos, music, cat videos if you want. There's also a lot of how-tos on YouTube. Like, how do I stop my dog from barking? How do I stop my cat from scratching my furniture? You can find videos for literally everything.
Need an account for this?
You don't need to view it. If you have a Google account, Google owns YouTube now, for a while now, actually. So if you have a Google account, you also have a YouTube account. And you don't need it to actually look at anything. It's just for subscribing to that area if you just want to keep going back to those videos if you like them. Just for quick access, like, you're probably subscribed to all these people here, probably.
No, I'm not subscribed to them, but what's happening is that because I view this stuff in my account, when I reopen my account, I can see what I've been looking at. If I don't have an account, I can't see where I've been. I have to go looking again.
You can actually just make an account straight from YouTube as well if you don't have a Google account already. But the main thing that you guys probably would be interested in on YouTube are the educational videos. And I know I do watch a lot of educational videos on here as well. Not quantum physics and stuff that will go up here, but there's a lot of people on YouTube that just give you information of things. There's a group on here called Numberphile, which is they're based in somewhere in England. and it's pretty much every teacher in this school for math, and they will teach you. Like, I've learned more from here than I have from school. Like, they will teach you, like, what's so good about pi or tau, or another version of pi, and stuff like that. They'll just talk about anything that has to do with numbers. Like, I'll just go to their number file with a PH for file. But yeah, they'll talk about formulas, hypotheses that people have made, why certain numbers are great and whatnot. I really recommend these guys if you just want to sit down and think for a bit. I typically watch these guys, even though half the time I don't understand what they're saying. I do learn, oh, this is what it is now. Sweet. I actually get smarter for a bit. Other people you can watch are Science. Oops. Maybe I need to look at how to spell. Science ASAP. These guys pretty much have a little cartoony drawing, some of someone drawing, but they'll teach you many things about, like, how much sleep do you actually need to function, what actually happens during an abortion, or introverts versus extroverts. It's just nothing but science-based products. ASAP, so yeah, it's ASAP Science, not Science ASAP. A good amount of people to find, just to make you think about things, is Vsauce. That's another good educational video. Actually, the owner of Vsauce, Michael Stevens, he is... Who here watched Mythbusters? Yeah? So, he's actually now working with Adam Savage from Mythbusters, from Discovery Channel. I forget the name of their show they're doing, but he's working with that, with him. He does many things like where what happens with Alzheimer's and the brain, and why are we so morbidly curious about things, and other stuff like that. Like, what's the most dangerous place on Earth? There's many interesting things on here. I always find myself coming back here. They also have a series called Dongs, Things You Can Do Online Now, guys. That's the name of their thing. But essentially, they pick out 10 to 15 websites that you can go to and either play games, learn something, see something amazing, like the biggest picture on the internet of London, I think it is. And they have many other things.
I don't get that. How can it be a big picture on the internet? I mean, it's because it's a screen.
It's because of how many pictures was taken. It's actually like two million photos all put together. So you can zoom up as close as you want and never lose quality.
Google Earth to the inch.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Speaking of which, Google Earth is a great free thing too. That's how I vacation. I just say I feel like going to Japan at Mount Fuji. It takes me to Mount Fuji. I'm like, perfect. And just spend time there. Vsauce also has Vsauce 2, which more deals with crazy things like stuff that can blow your mind. They have a series called Mind Blow. And essentially, like, you can learn about all the technology or stuff that people are creating as we speak. Like, there's a way now to smell with your tongue, or hear with your tongue. I forget which one it was. But like, you get to learn like all these stuff that people are making to try and help other people. And there's also some few things in here for science as well. You can just really look up many people. You can find even news. Oops, you can find news people here as well. I think CNBC is on here. Yep, there we go. So you can watch CNBC if you ever want to and watch the news. That's pretty much it. On YouTube, you can find pretty much anything to your heart's desires. These are just a few things and a few of my personal favorite people to watch for educational. Any questions about YouTube? No. Well, I just thought of something to say about YouTube. So, if you actually make an account, if you go to someone's place, we'll say CNBC in this case, just because I'm here, and let it load, and close here, you can subscribe to the channel, and pretty much anytime you go back to YouTube, you don't have to look for them again. You can just go to your subscription feed and see, oh yeah, I'm subscribed to these guys. Have they released any videos recently? If they have, I'll watch them. And I can just go back and watch things that they used to make. Like, if you just go to videos. And I want to watch some of the older videos, just sorted out by old. And there I have things from 3 years ago. Nothing rings a bell. Because I don't read the news anyways. But most of these are clips. They won't be like the full news coverage from so-and-so. It will just be a clip that will explain that news to you. So that's pretty much YouTube done and done.
I have a question now.
Yeah.
So if that's CNBC, so if there's two programs on the telly that I want to watch, and I don't have a VCR, I don't record, don't know why, I don't want to. Can I come to that and watch the other one that I missed?
If someone has recorded it for you, this is not live. This is all recorded from CNBC.
No, that's so, what I mean. Yeah. I can go back tomorrow night and watch what I missed.
It might be there. It might be there. It all depends on
typically, like, the shows won't be. If that's what you
mean,
yeah, shows won't be there. It will be just the clip from the
a newsy type clip. Some important news will be there. Let me just.
But you can search on YouTube.
Yeah.
So and so thing, like fifth season, episode three of show.
Yeah, I can't stress enough the importance of YouTube to help you do things. As an example, about a month ago, my snowblower was acting up badly. I couldn't get it to start. I'd be pulling on that cord for an hour.
Do you mean lawnmower?
The snowblower, remember?
Nah, I blocked out old memories. Old bad.
Anyway, him and I would be pulling on that thing for an hour, trying to get it to go. and it just would not go. I knew that there was whatever was wrong with it was something small, but I could not find it.
So we did.
I went to YouTube, entered the name of the snowblower and the problem. It brought up the first video, told me how to fix it in under 10 minutes. And it's been running like a champ ever since.
We haven't fixed the lawnmower.
Yeah. That's coming when it gets warmer. Years and years ago, I had a Jeep. And that Jeep gave me nothing but grief. Nothing but grief. Now, YouTube had not been invented then, but a service very like YouTube, without the videos, it was all text to tell you, you know, you could go to these places and it would tell you exactly, I've had this problem. I know what you're going through and here's the fix.
You need forum posts?
And all that Jeep needed was to have one electrical block taken off, have all of the grease, the electrolytic grease that was in it, taken out, the electrolytic grease put back new, put it back in the block, and I never had a problem with it again. That guy told me how to fix my Jeep that I've been having trouble with for a year, told me how to fix it in 10 minutes. I can't stress enough that there is an answer to your problem on YouTube with a video. And you can go there and you can follow along just simply by starting and stopping the video. Every time he gets to a place where he's talking about the new thing, stop and, you know, follow along. Undo the screws as he's undoing the screws.
Also, TED Talk is also on YouTube.
Yeah, TED Talks are also on YouTube. But I can't stress this enough, that YouTube can be the library of the future. To my mind, it is. And when you go to a library now with books, the books are all 10 years old, at least. On YouTube, the books are 10 minutes old. Okay? Or no more than a couple of months. All of that stuff is there for you.
Those red lines that told us some of those videos further down mean anything?
Yeah. The red lines just show you that you've watched the video and this is how far you've gotten.
Oh.
That's all it means. Like, she's go down to watch it again.
Oh, yeah. Okay. That means that I got to the end of it. That, except for the last 10 seconds, and I stopped it.
Yeah, and then on the third one, it's like, oh, you only watched like 10 minutes of it.
Yeah, so I may come back to that.
Yeah, okay. Just to show you
what you've watched and how much of it you have. Okay, that's it, folk. We're just about at 2 o'clock. I want to remind you once again that next week, we will not have a program 2 weeks from now, whatever that day is. And I will send you an email reminding you all. Thank you so much.
That's Computer Club Listen for today. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.